So, what's up everybody, and today I'm gonna give you a little guide on how to effectively do the Tabula Rasa achievement, which is the achievement that you have to do Hogs and Breakout on Overkill or Deathwish. I prefer Overkill, without having any skills equipped, using only a perk deck, a golden AK and a Chicago typewriter. I'm just gonna give you a few hints and just a guideline on how to do this effectively and doing it in one try, because I did that just 2 days ago with a friend of mine in the live stream, and it was going way too smoothly from the last time that we tried it. And I'm just gonna show you, or just give you an example why it was like that. First of all, the perk deck that you're gonna choose, yeah, that's a lot of XP. The perk that you're gonna have to choose is Grinder. What the fuck? Grinder is basically the overpowered way to do this. We both used Grinder and it was practically extremely easy to do. When we tried it the first time, we used the Rogue perk deck, which I haven't completed right now because I started all over again. Forced to start all over again. So I don't have Rogue anymore. But we used Rogue at the when we first tried it. And it took us around 4 hours. Just day two alone. I'm not gonna talk about day one. Fuck that. So basically, the Grinder perk deck. That should do. For the Golden AK, I have to make a few things really clear, and that is when you mod it, I'm using the modern barrel. Don't think about getting the DMR kit. Don't even think about it, believe me. Ammo efficiency is key when you're gonna do the Tabula Rasa achievement, because you want to keep that key card for the door and not for the fucking armory. You're gonna have to use one key card at least on a fucking med bay, and then the other one on the door for the escape. You don't want to use it for the armory just because you have a DMR kit installed on your fucking golden AK. So just keep that in mind. Otherwise, the Chicago typewriter is just the Chicago typewriter is how you want it to mod it. I have made for both of the weapons a review. You can see them when you do like this. You can see them right now on the right side. You just click them and you can see the review for yourself if you want to get it a little bit more in depth. But otherwise, they should be fairly similar. I haven't changed the Chicago typewriter, but I made the golden AK again. So I'm just going to show it real quick, just in case, using the modern barrel. Competitors, of course, auto fire, you know, extras, using the key mod rail, lead combo, aluminium grip, using the low drag mag for the more stability and mag size. The little mag size is good enough. Sights, using the C more as usual, and I'm using the classic stock for the accuracy and stability. You can go with the 2-piece stock, but we don't give a shit about concealment when you're doing a Tabula Rasa heist. So that's basically what has changed. The Chicago typewriter is the same. I know that one for sure because I never used it again when I made the review. So I know that it's the same gun. That's basically what I have to say about doing the heist. I actually did the did it with suits, because you have to use suits. So that's why things like let me see, muscle could be pretty handy as well, but I don't think it's enough. Armor is going to be pretty useless. Rogue is useful, but it's gonna take a while. Hitman, you can try out Hitman, but I don't think it's strong enough. Crook should be perfect for this. Oh wait, it's actually useless because you have to use armor for this and you can't wear armor. Burglar is gonna be pretty useless. Infiltrator, I don't know. Psychopath, I don't have it, I don't know. Gambler, no, you won't have the survivability. Grinder, OP. If you have Grinder, use Grinder. Yakuza, I couldn't try it out. Ex-President is actually also a pretty decent one. But I think that using Ex-President needs more dodge. So, I don't know. You can try it out with Ex-President, but I don't think it's gonna work. But I have to say this, I really have to try Ex-President for a long time before I can give a proper, well, basically just a proper opinion on how Ex-President works. Just keep that in mind. That's basically the basic stuff. Now I'm gonna go and show you the gameplay. The gameplay is basically how my guy looks like this. With skills. I just wanted to complete the heist with a few random guys in public. And I'm gonna give you some highlights and pointers of what happens basically. The weapons are the same, the stats are basically the same. The only difference is basically the damage for the Chicago, the damage for the Golden AK, and the ammo maximum size and the ammo pickup. They will be different, but otherwise it's basically the same. Also, for the melee weapon, I recommend using a weapon that has a pretty good knockdown. Because basically, on day 2, when they're gonna get that circuit box, the reload speed of both the guns are pretty low. So, using a weapon that has a pretty good knockdown effect should work, just to keep them down while you're reloading. Since you can buy yourself time. So that I don't get the fucking circuit box, which is pretty important, but I'm gonna keep that for later. So, after the gameplay. So at the beginning, on day 1, I made the mistake of bringing the cross skill with me. So the start of this heist, I'm basically gonna skip because I used the cross skill a lot at the start. And I realized it later that I'm using the wrong weapon. Alright, so one of the most important things that you have to do when you're doing day 1 and day 2 is that you keep reminding yourself that you have to use cover a lot. Cover is basically the most important thing that you have to do while trying to get a tabula rasa heist. Because basically cover means that you can't get shot at, and if you get shot at, they probably miss. And you have more time to recover your armor and, while using Grinder, be able to replenish your health more effectively. That guy didn't stand in cover and got down pretty easily, which is too bad. I have to watch for the snipers, that's why I'm gonna stand back there. He's not gonna hit me. And that's basically the most effective that I can be. As you can see, everybody's going down now. They're in the wrong place, I'm gonna make a big risk. When you're gonna do tabula rasa, this is going to fail. Because you're basically already dead. So, keep that in mind. Alright, so the most important thing that you have to do at the end of Hoxton Breakout day 1, which is not gonna happen in this video, because we all have skills and everything. But basically what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to protect the one that's lockpicking the door. If you are with more people, then you can take a bigger risk. But if you're just with 2, basically just keep defending the other guy while he's picklocking. It's going to take longer, but it's not about doing this as fast as possible. It's about doing this the right way and completing the mission and getting away with the achievement. The biggest problem that you're gonna have with the tabula rasa is if that bulldozer spawns on you, he's gonna destroy you in a few seconds, so you have to make sure that you're gonna throw a Molotov or anything, or a grenade, or whatever you're using. And make sure that you don't die. Try to stun him, try to burst him down with your golden AK, and just get it done as fast as possible. Of course, at the end, you're gonna have to scrap the car. Make sure that the one with the ticket has the right side, so you can just instantly use the ticket and get away as fast as possible. It's just the most effective way to do this, and then you should be done between the 8 and 10 minutes marks, if you do this right. If you have, like, an issue with SWAT venter that you have to, or the SWAT van that you have to drill, it's gonna take at least 1.5 minutes, and that's really gonna hurt your time. But it's fine, it's basically just another assault wave that you just have to survive, so it could be worse. After Hoxton Breakout Day 2, I brought a Thompson with me this time, so it's fine. The biggest problem that you're gonna have is probably the beginning. In the beginning, you have to take it slow. Those guards are going to destroy you. If this was on, if I was trying out the Tabula Rasa achievement, I would be already dead now. So, yeah. It's really important that you take the starting point really slow. Or pincer everybody down, but that's only doable if you talk to the other person in live chat, like TeamSpeak or Skype. Otherwise, it's not gonna happen. Me and my friend were too focused, so we didn't really talk that much. But hey, it's about being effective, right? Getting hostages is pretty important, because you don't have... you basically don't have doctor bags. So you have to see those hostages as your personal doctor bags. Never open that door. It's useless. It just means that the cops are going to get another spawn, which you really want to avoid. Whenever trying out the Tabula Rasa achievement in public games, I tried it out for, I think, 40 minutes in total. Most people in day 2 just close those doors so they can't get in, which, practically speaking, is a really good thing to do. I mean, you're just limiting their ways to get in and flanking you. But the problem is that they're gonna funnel in. And if you happen to kill a civilian or a hostage, well, let me just say that those shields are gonna barge in, and then all those tasers and cloakers and bulldozers are gonna get in, and then you're all dead. So don't do that. Let them flank. They will, if you theoretically speaking, there will be less enemies, because you can basically just flank them all at the same time while they are trying to flank you. Sounds really strange, but it does work that way. That guy actually fucked it up. Good boy, with your flamethrower. One of the most important things that I have to say is probably really watch your aim. You see me spraying a lot with the Chicago typewriter at range, but you shouldn't do this. I have fully loaded ace equipped in this footage, so I can just take the risk. And then while you're going for Tabula Rasa, you have to make sure that you're gonna hit almost every bullet. It's really important. Just, even if it's not a headshot, just try to get all those bullets in. The most important things about Tabula Rasa is the ammo efficiency and the damage. That's the most important thing. Survivability comes after that. Also, you have to make sure that the power will be on all the time, non-stop. You have to make sure that it's not gonna break down. It's going to cost 30 seconds. 30 seconds in 15 minutes or 20 minutes doesn't sound much. Well, it's just gonna mean that there's gonna be another assault spawn, and you don't want that. You want to keep the spawns as limited as possible. The less spawns, the easier. Also, you have to be pretty careful about when you're gonna use the keycards. I mean, you have that one thing where you have to try to find that document with all those bookcases and shelves. Don't use the keycard there. And why? It's really easy to defend that place. The same goes for the one when you have to get the FBI files. those investigation files. Don't use the keycard there. It's really easy to defend that spot. So just don't do that. The parts where I can say that you're gonna have to do those keycards, which are pretty effective, are the is the FBI computer on the lower ground where the spawn is for the snipers, you know, where the stairs are starting. And that's a great spot to use the keycard. Of course, the escape route with the last door. That's a great place to use the keycard. And there was another one. Oh, and the med bay. The med bay is also pretty important, because it just gives you more safety and you can risk a lot more if you have that open. You can take a lot more risks, because you can easily get out of gray that way. Alright, so let's talk about our most feared foe in Tabula Rasa, which is new. Let's talk about Captain Winters, or as how I like to call him, Captain Star Trek, because look at the way his fucking shields are. I mean, Jesus man, they look fucking strange. But anyway, trying to defeat Captain Winters is suicide. It's not gonna work. You can try to kill him, sure, but you're gonna burn through all your ammo, and it's not gonna be helpful. The best thing that you have to do is just try to avoid him, or make sure that he spawns in as late as possible. Me and my friend were lucky that he spawned in at the 18 minute mark, which we were trying to escape already, so it was fine. It was basically just a wall, we threw some molotovs in there, make him stun a little bit, get a little bit of damage in, and then just get out as fast as possible. But otherwise, just don't try to kill him. It's useless. Not gonna work. Well, it's gonna work, but you're gonna lose all your ammo. You're forced to open the armory, so I don't think it's worth it. The last thing that I have to say is that the person that will be chosen at the end, that's gonna bring the server, that's probably the guy that is as far away as possible from Gray. That's basically it. If you are like one death away from Gray, you're not gonna get the server. If you're both almost Gray, just one death short, then just decide, or just pick it, I don't give a shit, but just decide who's gonna get it. I let my friend use it, because I basically have the keycard and you can just open the door for him while distracting the Star Trek guy. And just make sure that he had a safe path. I think I'm better at that than moving bags, so I just did that and it worked fine. But otherwise, just don't bother with Captain Winters for as long as you possibly can. Just try to survive. I mean, look at it like this. You're using the grinder perk deck. You have to have units against you to regain your health. So look at it like that. It's basically free health regen if you take it easy and use your cover a lot. But that basically wraps up this video. If I missed anything, just tell me in the comments. I know it's just a pretty long video, but it could be longer. Look at it like that. If you still stick with me, then thank you for listening. I really appreciate it. And I hope this was helpful to you. So, thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you in the next video. Later, guys.